Dead next day. It's a black flight and your Chardonnay is a death row problem. 2 minutes too late. And isn't it ironic? Don't you think? It's like rain on your waking day. It's a pretty ride when you're already paid. It's a good advice since you just didn't take. And who are the figures? Is the plane safe? Was afraid to fly. No smoke inside on your cigarette break. It's like 10,000 spoons when all you need is a knife. So meeting the man of my dreams and meeting his beautiful wife. And isn't that ironic?
Amy, that was my favourite performance of yours. Like, out of everything you've done so far, that was the best vocal, I think, you've done. You just got into it. There's a way that you perform that is so unique. You just kind of go into your own world, yet you're so connected with everyone and everybody's connected to you. You kind of just, you're just feeling it. You move around the stage and you're feeling everything. So yeah, we feel it with you. And I just love the way you perform, because like you kind of just don't care. You're just like, you know, I'm doing my thing, I'm using my time. And you do, you really did. You made, that was the perfect song choice for you. And your vocals were fab. I just loved everything about it. Amazing, well done.
Emma, what did you think of the performance?
Yeah, I think it was an amazing song choice. I love how you softened it at the start and then just let go. There's something about you, I don't know what it is, but it just really intrigues me. Like, I get this impression when you perform on stage, you're really believable and you're genuine and you mean every word you say. And I think your voice has so much personality and like you had a bit of humour at certain parts, but then there was almost like this desperate part to your voice as well. And it's, you know, it's the first time I thought, oh, I want to hear her sing again, I want to hear her sing another song. But I think it is that sort of, that intrigue side because of the way you perform and you are so unique. I absolutely love that, well done.
Teddy?
It was definitely your strongest vocal. It was the most controlled I've heard you, and the amount of passion that you put into that performance. You really like pushed everything, you know, you put everything that you had into it. I really think the song was suited to you so much. But I loved how you changed it up just a little bit in places so that you weren't like mimicking Alanis Morissette. You were still being you. I just thought it was a really good performance. Like, you should be really proud of what you just achieved. Well done.
Anya?
I think it was a great song choice, and a very smart song choice for you, because it showed off like a lot of what you could do. It showed off how soft you could be and how much power you could put in. It showed off your belt that you haven't really showed us a lot of, but you definitely showed that off right there. And you're getting more confident every time you get up there. You kind of move around a little bit more and you get into your songs more. You're not afraid to like feel. And I just love that. I'm glad to see you growing so much. You should be very proud of what you just done.
Amy, after last week, I think you kind of like had like a wake up call sort of thing, because you let all that emotion out, get up to it, and then this week you come back with so much fight and fire, thinking, do you know what, I'm just gonna go. And that's what the beauty of tonight, what you did. It was definitely your best vocal to date. The performance side of things, I mean, that's something we're used to, as you bopping around. So it kind of blended really well tonight because of the song choice. You know, so it did work in that sense. But remember, if you do any ballads or anything in future, that's one thing you need to take control of. Other than that, you should be really proud of yourself. I think what you did tonight really, really shone. It was by far your best so far this season. Well done. Well done, Amy. Beautiful stuff.